Greetings to all. Welcome to the Vishal's LLB channel. In this video, we can understand the meaning and concept of the geographical indications and statutory provisions and the procedure for the registration of geographical indications, etc. Every region has its name and fame, qualities and characteristics of certain goods attributable to some geographical locations and reputable to as produce of certain region come under the geographical indications. And geographical indications is an emerging trend in intellectual property. Geographical indication of goods are defined as that aspect of industrial property which refer to the geographical indication referring to a country or to a place situated therein as being the country or place of origin of that product. Typically, such a name conveys an assurance of quality and distinctiveness which is essentially attributable to that fact of its origin in that defined geographical locality, region or country. And under Article 1, 2 and 10 of the Paris Convention of the Protection of Industrial Property, geographical indications are covered as an element of IPRs. They are also covered under Articles 22 to 24 of the trade-related aspects of intellectual property rights, that is called as TRIPS Agreement, which was part of agreements concluding the Uruguay round of GATT negotiations. India, as a member of that World Trade Organization, enacted the Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999 and has come into force with the effect from 15th September 2003. The TRIPS prescribes minimum standards of protection of GIs and additional protection for wines and spirits, Article 22 to 24 of Part 2, Section 3 of the TRIPS prescribes minimum standards of protection to the geographical indications that WTO members must provide. India, in compliance with its obligation under TRIPS, has taken legislative measures by enacting the Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999, which came into effect on 15th September 2003, and Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Rules 2002. As per the Indian Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999, geographical indication in relation to goods means an indication which identifies such goods as agricultural goods, natural goods, or manufactured goods as originating or manufactured in the territory of a country or a region or locality in the territory where a given quality, reputation or other characteristics of such goods is essentially attributable to its geographical origin. And in case where such goods are manufactured, goods, one of the activities of either production or of processing or preparation of the goods concerned takes place in such territory, region or locality as the case may be. The geographical indication tags are used in the following types of products. Those are handicrafts, food items, wine and drinks, industrial products and agricultural products, etc. Who can apply for registration? An application for the registration as an authorized user of the registered geographical indication shall be made by a producer and jointly by the registered proprietor of the said GA. Here the producer means any person who produces the goods in case agricultural goods and includes the person who processes or packages such goods, and any person who exploits the goods in case of natural goods, and any person who makes or manufactures the handicrafts or industrial goods, or any person who trades or deals in such production, exploitation, making or manufacturing of the goods. To whom we have to apply for registration? The application must be submitted to the registrar under the Act, the controller of the patents, designs and trademarks who are appointed under subsection 1 of the section 3 of the Trademarks Act 1999 shall be the registrar of geographical indications. He shall be assisted by the respective number of the officer which are appointed by the central government as they may think fit. A full modern patent office and the country's first geographical indications registry in Chennai, which is really a good step in this field. And the registry will further supplement this by meeting the requirements outlined in the Act. Every application should be filed in office registry of geographical indication within the territorial boundaries of the country or region or locality in the country where the geographical indication is situated. How to apply for the registration? Here are the steps to apply for the registration. The application for registration of a GI authorized user should be in the prescribed form according to section 3A and accompanied by the prescribed fee for filing a GI authorized user application with rupees 500 and a statement of case accompanied with an affidavit and a copy of the consent letter from the registered proprietor, or if consent letter is not available, a copy of the application may be endorsed to registered proprietor for information, and fees may be paid by cash or money order or bank drafts and checks, and it shall be addressed to the register of geographical indications payable at Chennai. Benefits of geographical indications. Here we can see the benefits of geographical indications. The organizations or companies who register their geographical indications enjoy various advantages. They are registered geographical indications have the exclusive right to access or use GI's products during the business, and authorized users enjoy the right to sue for infringement, and it provides legal protection to geographical science in India. And it prevents unauthorized use of registered geographical indications by others, and it provides legal protection to Indian geographical signals, which in turn promotes exports. And it promotes the economic prosperity of producers of goods produced in geographical area. And the next one is a registered owner can also approach for the legal protection in other WTO member countries. And finally, it provides legal protection to the respective goods in domestic as well as in international markets also. And the registration process of geographical indications. Here are the steps for filing the getting the registration of geographical indications. There are few steps. The first step is filing of the application, and it has to be checked if the indication falls within the definition of section 21E of the GI Act. And the association of individuals or producers or any association or authority should represent the interest of the producers of the goods concerned, and file an affidavit as to how the applicant claims to represent their respective interests. And applications must be made in triplicate, and the applications must be signed by the applicant or his agent and must be accompanied by a description of the case. And describe the special features and how those standards are maintained, and 3 certified copies of the GI related field maps and description of the inspection structure if there is any an area for regulating the use of GI, and provide details of all applicants with the address. If there are a large number of manufacturers, then collective reference applications for all producers of goods and GA should be made. If registered, if it is registered, it should be indicated accordingly in the register. The application must be sent in a respective address in India. And the second and third steps are preliminary examination and examination. The examiner will check the application for any deficiencies, and the applicant should take measures in this regard within 1 month of communication. The content of the case description is evaluated by an advisory group of experts who will master the subject, and furnished will ascertain the correctness of the description. After that, an examination report will be issued. The next step is show cause notice. If the registrar has any objection to the application, he shall file such objection, and applicant must reply within 2 months or apply for a hearing. The decision will be duly communicated. If the applicant wants to appeal, he can request it within a month. And the registrar also has the right to withdraw an application if it is mistakenly accepted after giving it on the occasion of a hearing. And the next step is publication in Geographical Indication Journal. Every application within 3 months of acceptance will be published in the Geographical Indications Journal. And the next procedure is resist registration. Any person opposing the G application published in the journal can file a notice of protest within 3 months. Another month upon request, which is to be filed before 3 months, and the registrar will provide a copy of the notice to the applicant. Within 2 months, the applicant will send a copy of the counter statement. If he does not do so, he is believed to have dropped his application. And where a counterclaim has been filed, the registrar will serve a copy on the person giving notice of the protest. Thereafter, both parties will lead their respective evidence through affidavits and supporting documents. After this, the date of hearing of the case will be fixed. Next step is registration of application. Where an application for geographical indication has been accepted, the registrar will register the geographical indication. If the date of filing the application after being registered will be considered as the date of registration, and the registrar will issue a certificate to the applicant with the seal of the geographical indicators registry. And the next step is renewal of application. A registered geographical indication will be valid for 10 years and can be renewed on payment of a renewal fee. Additional security for notified goods. The next step is additional security for notified goods, and an application can be made to the registrar for respective goods which are notified by the central government for additional protection for the registration of geographical indications in form GI-9. There will be 3 copies of the case details and 3 copies of issued notifications, and the application will be made jointly by the registered owner of geographical indications in India and jointly by all the producers of geographical indication. And the last step is appeal. Any person who is aggrieved by an order or decision which may prefer an appeal to the Intellectual Property Appellate Board, that is IPAB, within 3 months. Here are the remedies for infringement of geographical indications. Remedies relating to infringement of geographical indications are similar to remedies related to trademark infringement. Similarly, under the Indian Geographical Indicators Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999, falsification of a geographical indication. And the remedies are civil remedies and criminal remedies. In civil remedies, we have injunction, damages. And coming to the criminal remedies are more effective as compared to civil remedies because the former can be disposed of quickly. Pendency of civil suit does not justify a stay of the criminal proceedings, which involve the same question. Since criminal proceedings directly attacking the violator's owner and social status, in some cases he come forward for the settlement of the matter out of the court to save their reputation. And the punishment granted for the infringement offences varies from 6 months to 3 years imprisonment and a fine of not less than rupees 50,000, but it may extend to rupees 2 lakh rupees. However, the court for adequate and special reasons in writing may grant lesser punishment also. And one of the landmark cases, that is Bangla Rasgulla versus Odisha Rasgulla. In November 2017, the West Bengal State Food Processing and Horticultural Development Corporation Limited registered geographical indication as Banglar Rasgulla. It was reported that Bengal won the dormant war between Odisha and Bengal, which would own the famous dessert. The legal battle for GI registration started when objection to GI registration were lodged, and it was said that this famous dessert originated at Jagannath Temple in Puri, Odisha. An application to remove the registration of GI status was filed on February 2018. Meanwhile, the GI registry in July notified that Odisha did not give up in the race but won one. It is very important to note that GI, the registry, has not registered the word all Rasgulla and Rasgulla. It has prefixed 2 words specifically for GI tag. One is Banglar and the other is Odisha. To say that Rasgulla, Rasogola and Rasgulla is a general term which any person can use in his trade and business. Thus, as far as the law is concerned, neither of the two states has got a monopoly on the word rasogola and rasola. Therefore, it is free to sell sweets to anyone in the trade as rasgulla, rasgola, or any other synonym. What is prohibited is in the use of words Odisha rasgulla and Bangalore rasgulla by anyone other than authorized user under the law. Here we can see the list of GI tags in Andhra Pradesh. Those are Srikalahasti Kalamkari, Kondapalli Bommalu, Machilipatnam Kalamkari, Andhra Pradesh Leather Puppetry, Uppada Jamdani Saris, Tirupati Laddu, Gunturu Sannam Chilli, and Venkatagiri Saris, Bobbili Veena, Mangalagiri Saris and Fabrics, Dharmavaram Handloom Pattu Saris and Pavadas, Bandar Laddu, Udaygiri Wooden Cutlery, Banaganapalli Mangoes, Durgi Stone Carvings, Etikoppaka Toys, Alagadda Stone Carvings and Araku Valley Coffee, etc. And we have so many GI tags in India in different parts of the region. So, in simple, we can conclude that the GI tag is an essential component for creating and maintaining abstracts and originality of the product of certain essential and characteristics. And India is not far behind to legally pursue this aspect of intellectual property.